So yeah, we are progressing, but we need to take it easy, take our time. Don't rush. So now we are in permissive mode again. We did try it in enforcing mode, and we actually were able to log in and log out, although not everything looked the way it should look. But we're going back to permissive mode just to see if this quick helps us fix stuff quicker. Let's have a look. This doesn't actually. That's so messed up. Well, actually, here, fortunately, it did help a little with regard to abort. So that's nice. ABRT Apple. And then go to that for cache stuff here, and I'll paste it in for a while here. So it wants to remove name and create an unlinked link file there. See if we can figure out other stuff. This one here. Let's move this here. That reads a little bit easier. Like, same with this stuff. Let's just move that here. Because then you can see the path. First you need to traverse slash home to get to slash home my login user. So that makes it easier to read, to make sense out of it. Let's see what else we have. That's basically all. Nothing else is actually showing up. Kinda sucks. So, let's just build and just log out. But the files all are created properly. Let's just do another test. Let's see if our file context specifications are all working. So let's just restore con rvf home and then my login user. And we have some stuff that's getting reset, but that's just This is right. But this here is not right. So we need to fix this file context here. Deconf. So let's fix our file context. I'll just add it below. Paste. No. Let's just take care of our file context so that it is proper. And this is deconf config home to What else do we have? What's reset? Music was reset to audio home key. This sucks. This sucks. But we're going to ignore this one. Because for some reason. Alright, so this needs to be fixed as well. Telepathy mission control data home key in local share. This is a file transition issue that we need to fix. So search TPMC TPMC. Let's have a close look. Mission control. So actually we need another type transition there. We need another type transition here. Control. And this is telepathy mission control, wasn't it? Data home key, wasn't it? Yep. Mission control data home key on telepathy data home key. Telepathy data home key. And then we need to basically mission control data home key, allow that, and on data home key we need to basically do that, and let's think about what's happening. So we're creating a dear telepathy in data home, that's fine. And then we're with this, then we're actually so we're creating a dir telepathy in telepathy in what is it, local share. So we create that directory and then we add stuff to it. And then we basically need to also create, oops, also create a dir and add stuff to it, and it's mission control, and then also a file in there, mission control data. Yeah, this should be it. This should be it. It's a little bit complex, but that's nice because all these telepathy connection managers are storing their stuff in the same dir. So we want to basically make a distinction between various stuff. So we need to basically require the type. Require type. Telepathy mission control data home key. What a type. And then you save and see if that builds. And it builds. Let's load that into the system. Then we're going to SE module DB to hide stuff. Not sure if that's a good idea right now, but we're going to do it anyway. And then we're going to log out. Then we're going to clear stuff. So first we start by killing. Then we're going to clear stuff. And then we're going to lslvtemp remove any pulse audio stuff that's still there. rmrf temp pulse audio. Let's have a look at run user. Our user there is gone there. Let's add a new restore con. And there's nothing there. So let's now just set a force one and just pretend that let's search MABCTS 1209. We're clean. So let's just pretend that it's all fine and dandy and we're just logging in. But the music is still not, the sound is still not going. So, let's have a look. Yeah, we have link files that read by all these pulse audio things. So pulse audio home key there, and wherever that's done we're going to basically add it, but not here. Link file reads. Let's just open it as well. Next. This link file read, yeah. Let's just open that as well. Here we have that one that was conflicting. Damn. That sticky thing. So let's just clean out my keyboard. So let's read get attribute and open. Get attribute, read, open. This is not related. And here we are also missing. This is Canberra. So change that to Canberra. Canberra. Get attribute. Open and read. Next. Get out to create. Actually create. And it's so the opens were not actually needed. Let we know it opens. So that might not make sense, as I don't think symlinks are actually opened. So then we should just remove that, because else don't, if it doesn't make sense, then that's not good for reading it. All right. So what else? We have data convert searching. Data convert, and I should actually, that's not gonna happen. And it's related to this. Okay, that's good. So we're close, but no cigar yet. This is fixed. Config home P. This might make sense. Conf D2. I don't understand that. I don't understand that. It's probably checking for right. So let's just see if that's actually it. It's probably checking for right. Same for key sets. Actually, doesn't make sense this. Just right, nothing else. Let's just make this a allow for now. And now go to GSet. side 3, and it's a hunger 2. Tune this up a little bit as well. Let's just see what's going on here. So let's just have a look. Maybe it's just not logging what comes after this. For some reason, it's because it's impermissible. I don't know what. Maybe I'm just overlooking something. Test. And it's a comment. Allow this. And then make a comment, don't out it. And allow. Outlet access. Let's just hopefully that it will expose whether or not class the outlet, whether or not it's actually checking or it's actually doing it, trying to create something there. User agencies. Let's also till and 300 for log messages. Add it to allow. See if we're overlooking some. We don't. Make. And then also again check our contacts, see if we fix that properly. Restore com r v, and I won't do f, so that all at least don't bother with the DDM related stuff. My login user. So if all went well, then we will see only one for audit home key. And that's right. So we fixed everything. Nice. So we don't have to clear anything currently. What we're doing now is log off. That works. Nice. We're clean. And then just kill all the processes only. clears all the, also cleared there, just for shits and giggles. And also LSRLZ damped, just for shits and giggles. RMRF. Temp. Are we clean? Yeah, we confirmed that we are clean. Login. But audio is still not working. So we're overlooking. But we may be overlooking, but there's no audit messages at all. Oh, that's user ABC. Damn. All these no executes, I need to go and audit them all. No, I don't. Weird. And it's really just checking. Actually, let's just take it easy. First, let's fix this one. Canberra, getting attribute of pulse audio temp. And basically everything. So, pulse audio temp to, and just make sure that everything can get attribute. It's inherited. This is inherited, that right. So I'm just going to remove that because it doesn't make sense. Get attribute from this one. Don't make sense. It's inherited because it doesn't open it either, so it's opened already. Okay, so let's save it. the other issue. There are more issues. Here we have some stuff that still need to be allowed, data convert. Was it gconf home to gconf home to gconf home to search? And we have, oh, actually, so it does add something. So with regard to dset, it's just really slow. But it's actually adding something. Right, add name. So we'll see what it adds. It's really adding something. I should be looking what it adds, but I'll do that ASAP. This is dealt with. This should be ignored. And here is DM. So I'll just allow this in the our module. Because there's more that be here. Should be in the my ATM module, but eventually I'm probably going to put that all in this module anyways. Alright, so let's see that add name, grab add name, and see what it's trying to add, what name it's trying to add. Pulse cookie. And basically and a dir and a basically it's just trying to do the whole thing. So now we know. Let's go to Pulse Audio first. Pulse Audio. And let's see where the rules for Pulse could be and Pulse there. So here we have basically this stuff. This basically needs to. And basically everyone needs to be able to do this. Basically. GZD. Where is the full stuff? Yep. They all need to be able to do that. And then just change that. GZD. They all need to be able to do that. GZD. unfortunately, this is a named file transition, so that do. So we can remove that line all the way below this one. But all the stupid stuff that runs. So PA control. They all need to do that. And that's not a problem. Some library that they're using or something. Not these. Candleline needs to do the same. So that we have our house in order. This is Pulse Audio itself again. So we went there. Let's search gconf-d2 because that was trying to do some stuff in config. I can't find any more about that, so I'll just add a test though, by the way. Anyways, okay, let's see if this still builds. And I'm going to do a SE module B. I did that. I wanted to do that before, but I accidentally used DB. So SE module B this time to remove all the cruft. Okay, our log of wrong password. Log of see what we have. And with regard to SVN in particular, this seems okay. Seems okay. Okay, so what's the current status? 39. We're clear. Let's just kill. And let's just clear. At least let's see where this gets us. Get enforce. We're enforcing. We're clean. Let's log in. Sound seems to be working this time. But we do get AV signals. Let's see what that is. So we have a get attributes of password file. I thought I don't audit that. Okay, Canberra. Canberra. How would it be? 61.2. I'll just make this cleaner. So it's get attributes. So this one can be removed. But this one needs to get attributes. Actually. Yeah, homebrew. So let's just find all homebrew teas and add a get attribute just to, because it makes sense. So home root t, and that's it there. And then just make sure everything has a get attribute. I don't want to fall in that into that trap. And this one is a actually yeah no this one is a exception to that rule. So we have these sets. This one, I thought I don't audit it that. probably need to eventually allow it anyways. And then we are and it's probably trying to write Pulse Audio stuff there. So let's just grab that. Grab right. Actually, you can't see it right now. But let me guess. It's trying to do Pulse Audio stuff there. This sucks. That just does suck. Because yeah, Pulse Audio uses these random names, so I wouldn't be able to use a named file transition for that. So then I would basically have a rule that says, okay, if these settings creates a dir in temp, then it's automatically a Pulse Audio temp dir. And that's basically closes a lot of doors on me. And it doesn't seem to be actually, well, I'm going to just verify this first. I don't want to make any assumptions, although I'm pretty sure. So I'll just add it. D said D. Okay. Build that. But anyways, we're very close to a confined base. Now, all kinds of shit won't work. And this actually does work, I guess. Any new exit enough. We're just doing that. 12:47. No. So you can actually do that stuff. Let's see what happens if I try to execute gedit. Filter lines, permission denied. Let's see how that looks. So it's really simple there, boom, it can't allow generic binary files. So that's cute. So you can just only execute is allowed. It can log off. So, but that's actually probably just I'm not sure what it is. But this is kind of a nice base. Yeah, now of course DDM is hanging again, but that's unrelated. This is just a DDM bug. Every once in a while it just hangs. But cute indeed. So we logged off and we reloaded the policy. Let's just kill the processes. Clear again. And I see what it's trying to do, and I'm pretty sure that it's just trying to create Pulse Audio stuff, which I hate. But I guess we need to deal with it. We can't just ignore the facts of life. So let's just try that. Just have to deal with it. So here is our confined desktop. Let's see what we have. 48. Add name, just what I expected. Let me guess, Pulse. Yep. So that sucks. I'm only going to allow this for G settings. And then later, if I figure out that something else needs as well, then I'm going to allow it for others, but for now, only G settings. DZB, where's my fix? And then I'm going to first Pulse Audio. Pulse Audio. Let's see what Pulse Audio has then. Set and fix this. So boom, this can be all be removed. Not actually right to the soft file also. Right, and get attribute search. Get attribute search. Get attribute search tab. Get attribute search. Empty. And then fix that and hope to God that these settings doesn't use temp for anything else. That's messy. Build it. And we have search for file. I did that wrong. D7D. File search, and that's not right. You don't search files. That's just something you don't do. You search theirs. So I needed to go one up. So this is a little bit the base, but not quite. The base is that we also confine these apps that shell executes, like Boabab and Evins and Gnome Shell and stuff like that. That's the base, the real base. This is the semi-real base. So to speak. Okay. But let's just make sure that we're clean. We're clean. We're getting it, getting force. We're just clean. Let's see if we're still clean. We're clean. Cool. And we can peruse a little bit. There are too many issues. We do have this stuff here. Oops, that doesn't show. That doesn't look too good. This. So that's already one thing. Can't actually execute it, so we're stuck there as well. So we have some ABC denials. So you can't really do much. Just really the bare minimum what we have now. So we need to add this one. And here basically stuff is trying to execute. Abort applet, let's just grab for execute. Grab, execute. See what happens there. GPK, package kit, view the service. GPK, I think that's the new package kit. And then abort. But we can basically, we don't want this to happen. We don't want package kit in a guest. But we do want to basically allow the fonts for abort applet. So yeah, obviously there's still a lot of stuff to do. So that font stuff, let's see if we can find someone that has it. Of course, when you're looking for it, you can't find it. There are some rules coming to using fonts. good pawn set. I guess we need shell. Let's just do that because else I'm G shell. G shell uses pawns, so it's pretty obvious. So we'll just add these. This is basically for using pawns, and then add these to abort. ABRT apple. All these applets need to be able to use pawns, of course. So I'll just add them here. Then change it to abort. ABRT apple. Oops. ABRT apple. And the same goes for every troubleshoot. ABRT apple. ABRT apple. And then just look for every troubleshoot. As he applet. And it's the same deal here. Although I will just wait until this. Won't jump ahead of the conclusions. But that's why the menu didn't show, because it wasn't able to use fonts. And if it's not able to use fonts, then yeah, party's over, I guess. Log off. Log on to see if a board still comes up. Board. Damn. It sucks. And it's 1302. Let's see what we have at 1302. Nothing. So let's see if we can basically. Of course, this applet also needs it. Fonts. Oh, this one has fonts. Okay. So that's nice. Nice. So that works. That's nice. Now this network main. Now if I execute this, then it won't be allowed to execute, so I don't see. All this, none of this stuff you can execute. None of it. Neither the browsers, nothing. See? Just permission denied. Everything is permission denied. Except, yeah, it's still permission denied if I try to run Nautilus. I'm not going to do that now because I don't want to wake up the demons, demons. But actually, Kinum Shell is allowed to execute Nautilus, but nothing more. So, and it won't even domain transition. And we want to basically make sure that everything runs smooth. So we have some execute permissions denied. This one. Someone tried to run a program into Kinum Shell. So it's really nice. if you look, we can still can't actually do it from the shell itself, because but we should soon work on a confined GNOME shell. That will be nice, so that we can basically use that to have a shell in GNOME. Then that's the first thing I'm gonna try. That's nice project. So yeah, cool, really neat stuff. Now it's getting nice. So log off. Now it's getting nice. So this is kind of the semi base. So time to take a break. It's time to have lunch, and then after that I'm going to do the GNOME shell, I think. Confine the GNOME shell. That would be nice for today. Since GNOME shell is basically one of the programs that GNOME needs to execute, we need to focus on these, on GNOME terminal, on Nautilus Auto something, Boabab, whatever the hell that is. Nautilus, we need to confine Nautilus, we need to confine file roller and data press, and we monitor the system monitor and transmission and another Nautilus thing and IFGNOME and ePINs. We need to focus on those first. We need to take care of those first. And after we take care of those, then you can basically say you have a base. But that's a very lot of work. But we have something. So with that, I leave you.